There are hopes for TradFi use cases, as you know. I have here directly on the team several experienced TradFi team members that some of them I know from Saxon Bank, some of them from other financial institutions. So we have a fairly deep experience of the pain points in TradFi and the inefficiency in TradFi, and trust me, there are many. So we do understand the challenges these people face, and we do believe a number of these could be solved with blockchain in general, with Web3 ID, etc. So yes, we are in contact with several financial institutions in different jurisdictions that typically have particular interest in the ID layer and the efficiencies that could give them in terms of client onboarding and client lifecycle management system across multiple jurisdictions. So the short answer is yes, there are conversations and activities going on. The other thing I would like to mention is our own real world asset tokenization platform that we have released some of the code already on GitHub, and that will make it a lot easier for people to build real world asset use cases. In fact, just this morning we approved a grant to somebody that's going to use that infrastructure to tokenize real world assets. So with that, where we're going to have a full launch of that platform very soon, and people will tell you more about that in isolation and in detail. And that, of course, will be a helpful tool for people wanting to do RWA tokenization cases. So yes, we are looking at that space, and there's no question that blockchain can do a lot for the TradFi industry. There's also no question that very clear regulatory conditions and frameworks need to be in place for people to go into this for real. And that is, of course, a challenge across many jurisdictions that are holding back TradFi institutions from really engaging, although a lot of them are playing around with it and doing sandbox type things.